living on, I think that heart is going to keep ticking for a long, long time.
Classic country music right there. That is Tracy Lawrence, everybody. Coming up will be songwriting master Red Akins, and his son will be joining him a little later too. You may have heard of him. It's Thomas Rhett. See what we did there? Kind of an early Father's Day thing. Hello, friends. It is Bobby Bones. Welcome to Opry Live. for all of you watching us tonight on your local TV station, and I'm looking at you, Jonesboro, Arkansas, ABC Channel 8, and all of you in Odessa, Midland, Texas, CBS Channel 7, and you people with your jackets on in Fairbanks, Alaska on NBC Channel 11, and the rest of you across the country watching on your local channels. Hey, all your stations carry the Circle Network 24/7 on their sister digital channel, which means there's a whole bunch of other Circle shows just waiting for you. They're right next door on a nearby channel. Call in your name. Check your program guide to find out where your Circle is, or go to CircleAllAccess.com/watch. I promise you, you're going to love everything Circle has to offer. All right, this guy on stage is about as solid country as you can get. His songs reflect traditional country themes, love of family, friends, and faith. And most importantly, that our time on earth is very precious. That's the kind of guy I want making my music. Here is Tracy Lawrence.
Thank you guys so much. It is so good to see a packed house here at the Grand Ole Opry House. It's good to see Nashville getting back to normal and see our country getting back to normal. So honored to see all you folks coming and visiting our beautiful city and loving country music, because we sure have missed playing it for you. You know what? This is a very special year for me. I'm celebrating 30 years in the music business. I recorded my first album in 1991 in May. And so we're doing three albums this year. I'm dropping three complete packages, 10 songs on each album, celebrating that. So the first album is called Stairway to Heaven, Highway to Hell, and we've released several things off of it, and it is already out. Second album is called Price of Fame, and it includes a duet with my buddy Eddie Montgomery that just came out. So that second album will be dropping in August. And we're in the process of putting the final touches on that third package that will be out later in the fall. So our next two songs that we want to play are a couple of things off of our new album that's out right now. This first one's called A Whole Lot of Me. It goes like this.
That I run from responsibility, but I've only got one life and I'm gonna live it. Ain't nobody putting chains on me. I left some broken hearts in my rearview mirror, a couple that I love till my dying day. They always wanted more than I was willing to give, so I just dripped away. There's a whole lot of me. I've got everything, places still to see, people left to meet, this town yet to visit, roads still to drive, stars I ain't seen, and a Montana sky. I've got that to be, love still to make, dreams still to dream, there's fears yet to conquer before I die, and things are still laying dry. There's a whole lot of me. Most of them spend a lifetime with regret. Me, I found that hindsight's 20/20, and I see plenty. I keep on searching. desert, road still to dry. Stars I ain't seen in a Montana sky. Not me, I've got left to be. Love still to make, dreams still to dream. There's fears yet to conquer before I die. And things are still laying dry. There's a whole lot of me.
Tonight's Opry performance is in association with Shriners Hospitals for Children.
Well, hello to all of my live streamers out there. It's Natalie Stovall, and I am back at the Grand Ole Opry, and so is Tracy Lawrence. How amazing is that, kicking off tonight's show? Y'all, it feels so good to be back. I feel like I'm back home now. I've been on the road for a couple of weeks, and now I get to come back to home base for a minute, and it feels so good. It is packed in here. The energy is amazing in here right now. And I know that you guys were in such good hands last week with Miss Caroline Hobby and Miss Nan Kelly right before that. But it's so good to be here. And we have a lot new coming up. So there is a brand new show, Hitting Circle, which is so exciting. It's a very personal one for me. It's all about landmarks and the venues that made us. There's all of these landmark venues all around the United States. And there's quite a few here in Nashville. But they feature a different landmark venue in each episode. And you got to see a little sneak peek of that at the very beginning of the live stream. Mr. Charlie Worsham showing us Station Inn. And this week, they're going to be featuring Green Hall in Texas. And it's called The Landmarks, The Stages of Country Music. And it starts this Wednesday at 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. Central. So when they feature Green Hall, there's going to be a really amazing, heartwarming story from Willie Nelson about everything that he did to make sure that that beautiful landmark was not closed down. I've had the privilege of playing that place. It's such a cool venue. And if you keep watching, you might even see your girl at some point. I'm going to be talking about one of the landmark venues here in Nashville. And it's good news, too, because you can get circled just about everywhere. We are bigger and better and more places than ever. You can find us on Xfinity, Peacock, Roku, Samsung, Vizio, and the Zumo app. So pretty much no matter where you are, you can find Circle some way. I know the Zumo app is one of those that you can download on your iPhone or any of your smartphones. So make sure you look out for all of the new shows, but especially that landmark show. I'm very, very excited about that one. It's on Wednesday nights, 8 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. Central. I'm already seeing so many comments come in tonight. It's so fun because I saw Marmar says hello from Spain. I think that's the first time I've given a shout out to Spain. So shout out to Spain. We've got Canada. We've got all kinds of people. But right now we got more Grand Ole Opry. So I'm throwing it back to Mr. Tracy Lawrence, y'all.
Here's another song off of our current album that's out right now. This one's called Water. I wrote this with my friends Carson Chamberlain and Mark Nessler. Y'all might have heard those names before. It goes just like this. Circling in the sky, reminded me that I could die. And I don't find some water. I pray for rain and a little love. I sail my soul in a coffee cup. I swear right now there ain't much. I wouldn't give up for water. And know the drive in, right in the deep end. Like I ain't got nothing to lose. You can bet I'm thinking about drinking that cool, clear water. The first time that you kissed my lips, I felt
right then I had to get out of the heat of water. I know she runs hot and cold, but I'm not one to take it slow. Heaven knows I'd sell my soul for that tall drink of water. And on the diving, right in the deep end, like I ain't got nothing to lose. If I ain't sinking, you can bet.
I've been very blessed with a lot of big records over the years, and a lot of people would be surprised to find out that this next song did not go number one. It's not one of the 18 that I've been blessed with in my career. Would y'all believe Bank Me a Birmingham didn't go number one? This is probably the biggest impact record that I've had in my whole career. Can I play it for you tonight? We got a little live arrangement that we worked up just for the Opry. It goes like this. His brush in hand, painting waves as they danced upon the sand. With every stroke, he brought to life the deep blue of the ocean against the morning sky. I ask him if he only painted ocean sinks. He said, for $20, I'll paint you anything. Could you paint me a Birmingham? Make it look just the way I planned. A little house on the edge of town, porch going all the way around. Put her there in the front yard swing, cotton dress making early spring. Oh, well, she'll be mine again. If you could paint me a Birmingham. Canvas from a bag there by his side. Picked up a brush and said to me, son, just where in this picture would you like to be? And I said, if there's any way you can, could you paint me back into her arms again? Could you paint me a Birmingham? Make it look just the way I planned.
A little house on the edge of town, porch going all the way around. Put her there in the front yard swing, cotton dress making early spring. All while she'll be mine again. If you could paint me a Birmingham.
Goodness, for Mr. Tracy Lawrence. Y'all, was that not so special or what? Oh my goodness. Wow. Mr. Tracy Lawrence.
How are you, darling?
I mean,
I'm sweaty.
That's all right. I mean, that moment just then.
Oh, it's so awesome.
This is a little different than in July last year when you played with us. I mean, I'm sure it never gets old singing that song no matter what, but in that circle. What does that feel
that's
like?
That's really special. Opry is one of my favorite places to play, and there's always so much magic in this room. And to see this place filled back up to capacity, we are in a sold-out house tonight.
That's pretty amazing
to see everybody get on their feet at the end of the song. It's still unbelievable. We close our show with that song every night, so we like hearing that response. It's pretty awesome.
Everybody in the room was singing along. But I love Water. What a jam.
Thank you very much.
So is that the first time you've played that in front of people?
Oh, no. We've been playing it on the road for a little bit. So we've been playing a lot of stuff off the new projects already.
Yeah,
we went back to work probably around February, and we've been on the road pretty much every weekend doing 2 or 3 days a week. So we've been working a lot.
That's amazing. Yes. Well, you sure are an overachiever, releasing three albums this year.
Yes.
Is that what you did? Was just write all of quarantine?
A lot.
In between going to Tractor Supply, I heard.
And cutting firewood and bush hogging the pasture and all that good stuff.
Well, we love having you on the Opry. Thank you for taking a second to
chat
with us. Have a good night. Tracy Lawrence, y'all. How cool was that? What a beautiful moment. This night has already been filled with so many of those already. And we have had so many incredible moments, even when things were a little bit different and weird for us here at the Grand Ole Opry. And what we've done is capture this last crazy year in this incredible limited edition LP, Opry Unbroken. Now, if you go to Opry.com, you can get yourself one of these. This album captures so many of those incredible magic moments that wouldn't have happened if it hadn't have been such a strange time for all of us. But we got to see artists in a very unique setting with no crowd, getting to talk to each other and share stories with one another. And some of the best moments of that are captured here. So go to Opry.com, get yourself some Opry Unbroken. Right now, we got more Grand Ole Opry to get to. I'm throwing it backstage to Bobby Bones.
Welcome back to Opry Live. Hello, friends. It's Bobby Bones. If anyone has a golden touch with a songwriter's pencil, it's this next guy. It seems like he's co-written number one songs for just about every male artist in country music. I mean, check this. He's co-written a number one song for Joe Nichols, Josh Turner, and John Party. He's co-written 2 number ones for Luke Bryan and Dustin Lynch. And 3 number ones for Blake Shelton, Jason Aldean, and of course, his pride and joy, Thomas Rhett. I mean, that is a crazy amount of talent, right? I got to find out what vitamins he's taking. On top of all that, he's a pretty dang good singer, and he is a great guy. Here is Red Akins.
How you doing, Grand Ole Opry? She's been going out with him, and she's been going out with me since she let us know by tonight which one it'll be. So I waited by the phone, but she never called me up. Had to know what was going on. I drove by her house, and sure enough, that ain't my truck in her drive. Man, this ain't my day tonight. Looks like she's in love. Sitting here all night, just wondering what it was that I did so wrong, that he did so right. I thought of breaking down that door, but there's nothing left to say. That Chevy 4x4 says it all, and it's sitting in my place. That ain't my truck. My name is Red Akins, and I'm so proud to be here. I love playing at the Opry every chance I get, and standing in this same block of wood that Hank Williams stood in, and Minnie Pearl, and Roy Acuff, and Bill Monroe, and all the greats. And but tonight might be the most special Opry appearance I've ever had. I get to play it with my son tonight, Thomas Rapp. I played here for the first time in 1992, and he was over there. He was only 2 years old. And believe it or not, my 15-month-old is standing over there right now. And y'all come back in 30 years, and he'll be playing, I hope. But I love the Opry. I love the history of the Opry and all the Opry members. And one of my favorite Opry members is Blake Shelton. And I've been fortunate enough to write a bunch of songs for some of my buddies, and this is a song that I wrote for Blake. And I hope you know this. If you know it, sing along. This one goes out to all my
red, 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 red. Listen to the Beatles, run old Bo Cephas through a jukebox, needle at the honky-tonk, where they boot stomp all night.
That's right.
And now what they call work is digging in the dirt, gotta get it in the ground for the rain come down to get paid, to get the girl up in your four-wheel drive. Yeah, the boys round here. Legit, they don't take no lip. Shoot it back and shoot it back and shoot it back and spin. Hey! Oh, heck, red, 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 red. All right, this side, let's see what you got. What you got? Now the boys around here are keeping it country. Ain't a damn one know how to do the Dougie.
You don't do the Dougie?
No, not at the Opry. But the boys around here, yep, still love me. Yeah, the girls around here deserve a whistle, shaking that sugar sweet as Dixie Crystal. They like that yawling, southern drawling, just can't help it cause they just keep falling for the boys around here, drinking that ice cold beer, talking about girls, talking about trucks, running them red dirt roads out kicking up dust. The boys around here, sending up a prayer to the man upstairs, backwoods legit, don't take to the countryside. Come on, Opry, like this.
That's right.
Down to the riverside. Now, hey now, girl, hop inside.
Ooh,
me
right.
And you, we gonna take a little ride to the river.
Ooh,
yeah, we gonna ride. You gonna ride. Lay a blanket on the ground.
That's
kissing
right.
And the crickets is the only sound. We out of town. Tell me, Opry, have you ever got down with a red, 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 you wanna get down with a red, 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 red. Let me hear you sing, Opry. Yeah, the boys drinking that ice cold beer, talking about girls, talking about trucks, running them red dirt roads out, kicking up dust. Boys round here sending up a prayer to the shoot it back and spin. Thank you so much, Grand Ole Opry.
Rhett Akins, everybody. No fun at all tonight here at the Grand Ole Opry. Okay, so Rhett has given some interviews talking about writing that song. I think the writing of it was just as much fun as any performance of that song. It was him and Dallas Davidson and Craig Wiseman together. They were just cutting up and having a good time. They never once in their wildest dreams thought that anyone would cut that song. But as soon as Blake Shelton heard it, he was like, I'm cutting it, and I'm cutting it with all those ad-libs in there. It's just so, so delightful. Now, speaking of other delightful things, we have a show that we have talked about a few times already, but I want to make sure that you guys are aware of it. It's called Talking in Circles with Clint Black. Now, Mr. Clint Black, we all know what a talented musician and songwriter he is. He's also quite the conversationalist. And so he sits down with lots of other artists and hangs out, and he draws a lot of really fun and interesting stories out of his friends. So he talks with artists such as Travis Tritt, Trace Adkins, John Rich, Amy Grant, Darius Rucker, and Talking in Circles comes on Saturdays at 10 p.m. Eastern, 9 p.m. Central. So right after the Grand Ole Opry, be sure and tune into Circle and find Talking in Circles with Clint Black. Okay, it's time for one of my favorite segments that we do every single week here at Opry Live, which is the Circle Release of the Week. This week, we are featuring a guy named Larry Fleet, And his song is Where I Find God. Now, I'm being introduced to this one as well, but when I listened to it from the moment that those lyrics started, I mean, I was in. This song is so beautiful. It's all about finding God in those moments that are sometimes unexpected, sometimes right where you'd expect to find him, in a church pew, but also moments alone in your car or when you make a mistake and somebody's helping you out. This song is so special. Also, his story is really special too. He's one of those guys that was in town grinding it out for over a decade. Things weren't working out. He was starting to think about hanging up his hat, and he went into construction and masonry, but he was still performing a little bit, and he played at this private event with only 20 people, and Jake Owen happened to be there. Took him on the road, started helping him out a little bit, and now he's got a song that we all need to listen to. So check out Larry Fleet, Where I Find God. I'm going backstage now to Bobby Bones, y'all.
Welcome back to Opry Live. Hello, I'm Bobby Bones. Well, I told you how talented Red Akins is. Well, this next guy is definitely a chip off the old block. Like his dad, he got a start in this town as a songwriter. He quickly proved himself to be a skilled vocalist. You put two together, you get an authentic country musician, one who knows what he's singing about and sings what he knows about. The bottom line is, he is the real country deal and certainly one of the most valuable players of the country music industry. Here is Thomas Rhett.
How we doing at the Grand Ole Opry tonight? We're gonna start off with one that you know, if that's all right. This song's called Die a Happy Man. It goes a little something like this. Y'all feel free to go ahead and put your cell phone lights up or whatever you feel like doing at the Opry tonight, all right? Baby, last night was hands down one of the best nights that I've had, no doubt. Between the bottle of wine and that look in your eyes and Marvin Gaye, then we danced in the dark under September stars and the pouring rain. And I know that I can't ever tell you enough that all I need in this life is your crazy love. If I never get to see the northern lights, or if I never get to see the Eiffel Tower at night, oh, if all I got is your hand in my hand, baby, I could die a happy man. How about y'all tonight? Me to my knees, oh, but that black dress makes it hard to breathe. You're a saint, you're a goddess, the cutest, the hottest masterpiece. It's too good to be true, nothing better than you in my wildest dreams. And I know that I can't ever tell you enough that all I need in this life is your crazy love. If I never get to see the northern lights, or if I never get to see the Eiffel Tower at night, oh, if all I got is your hand in my hand, baby, I could die a happy man. Oh, you know I could. Drive a sports car up the coast of California. What with all I got is your hand in my hand. Baby, I could die a happy man.
Opry's on fire tonight, baby. I'll tell you that.
I tell you what. Just because tonight is so special, can I hear y'all sing one chorus with me? Is that okay? If I never get to see the... Praise God. Thank you so much, y'all. Appreciate it. Oh, my goodness. This feels so special to be here. Thank you so much to stand in this circle right here. I'm going to play you a new song. Actually, it's not new. It's on the radio right now. This is our current single. And if you've heard it, we'd love for you to sing along with us. This song's called Country Again, and it goes a little something like this.
Been a year since I seen a deer, had a small mouth on the line. The other day I hooked a monster, and as I reeled him in, I thought, man, it feels good to be country again. I spent way less time in Nashville and more time in LA. They quit calling, thought I had too much on my plate. But last night we cracked some cold beers and cranked Eric Church to 10. I thought, man, it feels good to be country again. Yeah, I love me some California, but it sure ain't Tennessee. And my roots down there in Georgia, yeah, they started missing me. And I wouldn't change the things I've done or the places that I've been. Man, it feels good to be country again.
Can I get an amen in the Grand Ole
Opry? I traded in my Silverado. I didn't need no 4x4. Tucked my boots in the back of the closet. They didn't feel like me no more. But I dug them out. Slipped them on, they've been on my feet since then. Man, it feels good to be country again. Yeah, I love me some California, but it sure ain't Tennessee. And my roots down there in Georgia, yeah, they started missing me. And I wouldn't change the things I've done or the places that I've been. Man, it feels good to be country again. I traded sunsets with my wife for hours on my phone. And even when I was right beside her, I still wasn't really home. But last night we built a fire, watched the moonlight kiss her skin. Thought, man, it feels good to be country again. Man, it feels good to be country again.
Thank you.
Thomas Rhett, everybody. Thomas Rhett Akins Jr. with his father on the stage tonight, Thomas Rhett Akins Sr. Y'all, I can't believe that this night is already almost over. I feel like I just got here, but that's always the sign of an amazing Grand Ole Opry night. It is just, it's so good to be back. And I've seen so many of you commenting tonight as well, how exciting it is for y'all to be tuning in on such a glorious evening. Now, we talked about this a little bit, but I was so excited about my Tracy Lawrence chat, I didn't get to talk about it enough. But I want to make sure and mention once again all about Opry Unbroken, this incredible vinyl record that they have created, highlighting some of the best performances of this last year. Now, this last year was really weird for everybody, but there were some beautiful things that came out of it. And one of the things that happened was seeing so many unique performances from some of our favorite artists and getting to see them in ways that we would have never gotten to see them otherwise. That night that Rodney Crowell and Emmylou Harris and Vince Gill all played together up on stage, and they were telling stories about one another and all the bands they've been in together and separately and songs they've written for one another was so cool. This also has Brad Paisley, Carrie Underwood. It's got Darius Rucker, Keith Urban. You've got to check this thing out. Go to Opry.com and get yourself a copy. And by the way, the first 2,000 folks will also get this special Hatch print poster. The Hatch print posters are some of my favorite. They always make special posters for the shows at the Ryman Auditorium. And this right here, the first 2,000 lucky individuals to get this album, you'll get one of these. So make sure you go to Opry.com. What a beautiful keepsake. I can't wait to get my copy of this as well. And y'all, next week on the Opry, get ready for this. LV Shane is going to be here. He's another one of our Opry release of the weeks that we've had, the Circle release of the week. We featured his song, My Boy, just, it was like a month ago. And get ready, get your tissues out. I got to actually play with him with Runaway June last week on stage, and there wasn't a dry eye in the place when he sang My Boy. Also next week on the show, Kyle Petty, Josh Turner. Oh, I love me some Josh Turner. Sawyer Brown's going to be here too. So make sure you tune in again next week. And that's it for me tonight. Y'all have a great night. Going backstage to Bobby Bones.
Welcome back to Opry Live. Huge thanks to Tracy Lawrence, Thomas Rhett, and Rhett Akins for making our Saturday night perfect. All right, before we head out, here's a little something special from Thomas Rhett. Good night, everybody.
This song's called 16. Y'all sing it out with us, all right? Take a left here, boy, but take it slow. And don't get distracted by that radio. I just rolled my eyes and I said, Daddy, I know. I'm 15, I ain't green like some old 10-year-old. What I wouldn't give to be 16, wild and free, cruising up and down Main in my F-150. Roll the windows down, bass too loud from this burnt CD. I'll be right where I wanna be when I'm 16, 16, yep. 16. Finally feel alive, but I got this curfew. Sneaking in late, smelling like my girlfriend's perfume. People talking about college and knowledge, and that's alright. But all I'm thinking about is an unsupervised Saturday night. What I wouldn't give to be 18, wild and free. Buzzing off a can of that grizzly wintergreen. Looking old enough to pull off this fake eye. Say the grass is always greener, and I believe that's right. But all my friends came out to the Grand Ole Opry tonight. They left me behind. What I wouldn't give to be 21, wild and free. Open up a cold one and drink it illegally. Chase a bunch of girls, go see the world, let my wild
down the street or run. I'll be right where I wanna be when I'm 21, 21, yeah. Drinking wine with my wife at home. Got a couple dogs and a couple songs on the radio. And we sit around and we laugh about how we used to be, when all we cared about was turning 16, 16, yeah. When all we cared about was turning 16.
Grand Ole Opry crowd came out to party tonight, didn't it? Y'all, I know Dad touched on this a minute ago, but y'all understand how freaking cool this is right here. It's the craziest thing in the world. So we're gonna play you a song together that we wrote together. This was the first single off my latest album. And what you got to say, Dad?
This is unbelievable. I mean, you were over there at 2 years old watching me play, and we've written songs in the kitchen since you were about 8 years old, and now we're singing one on the Grand Ole Opry that we wrote that went to number one. Thank you, Lord.
Let's go.
Thank you. Thank you.
This song's called What's Your Country Song, and it goes a little something like this.
Did your daddy let you drive? Are you whiskey been hellbound, even though your mama tried? Did you cruise down a back road with your Dixieland alive? Are you on a Chattahoochee on a barefoot blue jean night?
Everybody got a small town anthem. Everybody got a story to tell.
Do your exes live in Texas? Are you so lonesome you could cry? Are you heartbroken cause you know that ain't your truck in or drive? Are your friends out in low places underneath the neon moon? Were you already country back when country wasn't cool?
Y'all sing it out with us right here.
Cause everybody got a small town anthem. Everybody got a story to tell. Everybody got
yeah, what's your family tradition? What makes you turn it up, make you raise your cup every time you listen?
Hey! Everybody got a small town anthem. Everybody got a story to tell. Everybody got a hallelujah. Everybody been through a little hell. When you're rolling down a two-lane highway and you turn your radio on, tell me which one hits you, baby. Yeah, what's your country song? Yeah, what's your country song?
Y'all, what is life? I mean, this is what dreams are made of right here. I'll never forget my very, very first Opry experience. I think this was in 2012, standing in this circle, not having a dang hit at all. And now we're here standing with my dad. This is absolutely unbelievable. So thank you for showing up tonight and showing out. It means so much. Y'all got time for one more? Can I play you one more? So in lieu of Father's Day coming up in a couple weeks, I'm gonna release a new song in a couple weeks. And I've never played this song for anyone except for my dad. I wrote it with my dad, and I played it for my wife. She thought it was good, so I thought I'd play it for you guys tonight. So of all the songs me and dad have written together, this is probably one of my favorites. And if I mess up the words, y'all just scream in place of them, and I'll find my place. Deal? So this song's called Things Dads Do, and it goes a little something like this. Make you mow the grass and do it for free. When you think you're done, they'll say rake the leaves. They'll say it builds character, but it's 90 degrees. You'll cuss him under your breath. He won't let you quit your football team or hang with the kid that lives down the street, 'cause he heard he smokes dope and got holes in his jeans. Looking back, he was right, I guess. Your things dads do, you act like he does when he don't have a clue. And I know it seems like he's flying by the seat of his out-of-style jeans. You'll get embarrassed when he ruins your cool, when he pulls out his camera on your first day of school. And that's just a few things dads do. Hand you the keys to a hand-me-down truck and take them right back when you tear it up on your first broken heart. To say, son, tell you what, let's talk it out over a beer. And when you get married, he'll be best man and pay for the booze and a bad cover band. And he'll give a long speech and say this was God's plan. But try not to cry, but he will. The things dads do, give you his old recliner for your new living room. He'll call too much and out of the blue without asking to show up. He'll give you advice about your career, complain and ask why your fridge is full of weird beer. That's just a few things dads do. Sit in the waiting room chewing Red Man till the doctor comes out and says, y'all come on in. He'll say she looks perfect, then shake your hand and say, now you'll understand. Things dads do, you'll think it's crazy until you want to, and you'll lose your mind. In a couple years sleep in just 3 months' time. The next thing you know, one's five and one's three, and one's almost one. She's cutting her teeth in your his shoes, and you're starting to do more than a few things dads do. Things dads do, your things dads do. Thank you so much, Grand Ole Opry. It's been such a pleasure playing for you tonight. Make a huge round of applause for this band. One more time for my daddy, Red Akins, and one time for Mr. Tracy Lawrence, y'all. God bless you.
Standing ovation in Grand Ole Opry. Thomas Rhett, ladies and gentlemen. What a Saturday night in Music City, USA. Oh,